Hi, these little guys are MQ2 and MQ5 gas sensors. They look identical and you can probably tell them apart only by the labels. Both require exactly the same connections, but they detect different gases. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use one of them with Arduino. We'll be reading values from the sensor and make the Arduino light an LED when gas concentration rises above a certain level. To build this project, you'll need a few things. A 5V DC power supply that can deliver at least 0.3 amps. An MQ2 or MQ5 gas sensor. An Arduino board. A breadboard. A few wires. An LED. A 120 ohm resistor. A resistor close to 20K. A piece of heat shrink tubing. And a gas lighter or torch. Let's start playing with the sensor. A gas sensor has 6 pins. These two middle legs are heater coil pins. Don't worry about polarity, it's not important in this sensor. The next two legs are A pins and they should be connected to each other. The last pair is named B and these two pins should also be connected to each other. I'll connect my wires to the sensor using heat shrink tubing. Now let's connect the sensor to the breadboard. One of the heater coil wires goes to the positive rail and the other one to ground. Connect both A wires to the positive rail on the breadboard. Hook up the B wires to the same row and to ground through a 20K resistor. A jumper wire goes between the B pins and A0 pin on your Arduino board. Connect your breadboard ground rail with the Arduino ground pin. Hook up your LED's negative lead to ground and the positive lead to one of empty rows on the breadboard. connect a 120 ohm resistor to the positive lead of your LED. In the other end of the resistor, through a jumper wire to your Arduino's pin number 8. Connect the jumper wire to the positive rail on your breadboard and another one to the ground rail. Hook up your power supply to these jumper wires and the Arduino to your computer. Download the code from my website and upload it to your Arduino. You'll find a link in the description below. Now go to Arduino IDE, select Tools, Serial Monitor, and you should see a value between 0 and 1023. If your sensor detects gas, the value goes higher. Readings from the sensor are reliable after about 2 to 3 minutes after powering up. After about 3 minutes, you'll notice the readings will go lower and stabilize at a certain base value. Now I'll try to give my sensor some gas from a mini torch. As you can see, the value increases instantly. When it reaches 500, the LED lights up. You can adjust sensitivity by changing the sensor value in the code to match your needs. Now you know how to use a gas sensor with the Arduino. If you have any questions or want to add something, feel free to write a comment below. If you like this video or find it useful, you can support me by sharing this tutorial with your friends, giving me thumbs up, or subscribing to my channel. Knowing that you appreciate my work really helps me make more videos. Thanks for watching and see you next time.